Hi, Internet. Welcome to the Grad Touring YouTube channel. It is Thin Lizzy Thursday. This Thin Lizzy Thursday is brought to you by Plug, Radiant Epic. Read it, please. More on that later. Okay, so, we're doing sort of an alternating thing, going back and forth between the computer randomly choosing what I'm going to listen to, and then you get to see my face where I'm like, oh, I can't believe that's the song it chose, and letting you wonderful people vote based on four choices from the computer. So, you know, to prevent Blatstar Riders from happening on this channel. And the fan vote, it was a pretty decisive winner. We are doing Fight or Fall off Jailbreak. Spoiler alert, I like the song. And it's just like just at the cusp of love. So like, I do like it quite a bit. I think it is a great song. But in a catalog of so many great songs, I probably rank it a little bit lower because the competition is so stiff. You know, this one is a little bit more mellow. But I still think it's cool. Like I said, just like with so many great songs, it has to rank somewhere. So when I saw that this was the one that was picked, I was like, yeah, okay. Because, you know, Jailbreak is the most popular Lizzy album, generally considered to be their best. I'm more of a Black Rose guy, but Jailbreak is my number two. So, I mean, it's a great album. It's a great song. But when I saw Sisters of Mercy was on the list, I'm like, ah, I want this to win, but it won't. So, you know, hoping that random number generator gives me Sisters of Mercy next week because, ooh, that was such a tease. But you know what? Instead of, like, comparing this to other Thin Lizzy songs that I would have rather reacted to, you know, I want to, like, savor it and enjoy it for what it is because it is a cool little tune. And I've got it pulled up. So let's just dive right into this bad boy. See how I'm feeling today listening to Fight or Fall after not listening to this one for a while. Yeah, so right at the beginning, you know, early pause, but it's like, it's a mixture of like, it has like kind of a little bit of like a funk edge to it, soulful, but also it has a bit more of a snappy beat than you get from that genre and kind of turns into like a mixture of like, you know, funk and soul meets like Irish swing, which, you know, is a cool combination and is very unique. So rewind just a hair, get back to it.
Brothers, here I stand. Spread my wings and take command. Sky, he just a man. The boy become a man. After all this time, tell myself that I'm not just wasting time. Oh, you know I'm not that way inclined.
You know, I think I might have needed this today. I've been kind of going, like, nonstop, hard, like, go, 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 go. Like, the, what, last month? No, 2 months ago. Shoot, it's becoming a blur. So 2 months ago, I was working two jobs and overtime at my main job, so it was, like, you know, 60 hours a week, and had to, like, rearrange my schedule that month for, like, a bunch of crazy stuff, and it was just exhausting. And then I was like, oh, sweet, hell month is over, I can finally relax. And then, you know, we went on vacation for a couple days, and then when we came back, we had fleas. The cats had fleas from the vacation. You know, celebrated my wife's birthday, went to the beach because she wanted to go to the beach, and we took the cats with us, and then we got fleas there, which is super obnoxious because, like, you know, did the, you know, rearranged on the schedule to make sure that I could give her the nice birthday trip, which I'm glad to do, but that was, like, an exhausting thing to do, just, like, the overtime hours, and then like crunching a bunch of hours together so that I would have the time off to do that and like finishing up the second job. So I was exhausted from that, but I'm like, okay, whatever, at least, you know, it's finally over and she got the happy birthday. But then when we got the fleas, that meant like 4 hours of cleaning each night of like, you know, spraying the house, vacuuming, flea combing the cats, etc. So that marathon never really stopped, and I've just been kind of going. And to listen to something a bit more mellow is, you know, is nice. Like, and the fact that it was sort of like, I would say, forced upon me in a way, where I might not have sought something mellow at this point because I'm like, I'm trying to keep that energy up, staying pumped and whatever. But, you know, I think you just need to sit back sometimes, especially after all the go. So, you know, it is a great song. It's so indicative of the 70s and stuff you don't get anymore. Just the simpleness of the vocal production is very charming. You know, very just like mellow vibe, you know, just evocative of that decade and stuff that you don't get from newer bands. Lyrically, let's see what it says. Brothers, here I stand, spread my wings and take command. The sky he justly planned, the boy become a man. After all this time, I tell myself I'm not just wasting time. Oh, you know, I'm not that way inclined. And then it goes back into the musical hook. I think this is one of those ones where there's not really a chorus necessarily. It's just sort of verses like a poem, and then you get like a musical hook which serves as a chorus, which Lizzie does a couple times. The melody is catchy. Lyrically, I believe this is sort of an Irish independence song about, you know, standing together with your fellow Irishmen. You know, Jailbreak was considered to be a loose concept album where instead of Ireland, it's like Space Ireland. The boys break out of jail and then they fight for freedom for Space Ireland. I'm doing this in a very reductive way, describing the story. But yeah, so it's just about unification, your kinsmen, you know, the people of your tribe coming together. And, you know, I think the sentiment is good. I think the melody is good. I think it's all around pretty good. So let's get back to it.
Brothers, if you hear, raise your flags and make it clear. There is more to fear if we wait for another year. After all this time, I tell myself that I'm just passing through time.
Yeah, some great O's from Phil there. The telling myself part, telling myself, and sort of like the back and forth vocal is really, really excellent. And you know, I'm loving the simple doubling of the vocal. Maybe it's a tripling. It's a very simple production technique that, you know, I have utilized, where basically you do a vocal take, and then you do another vocal take on top of it, but you make the timing of the two slightly off so you get an effect. And it sounds cool. There's a lot of different ways you can use, doubling. The most common way to do it is just make a vocal track sound stronger. And so the idea with a lot of vocal doubling is that you're not even supposed to hear it. It's, like there's, the vocal performances are so in unison that you don't necessarily notice that there's a doubling effect, but it just makes the vocal sound stronger. But you can intentionally do a vocal doubling effect like this, where it creates a unique sound. You know, most vocals, unlike, you know, recordings, there usually is like a doubled vocal. It's usually not a single vocal track, and just you don't notice the doubling. But this is very deliberate and very cool. Lyrically, brothers, if you hear, raise your flags and make it clear. There is more to fear if we wait for another year. So basically saying, you know, the time for independence is now, the time for freedom is now, the time to stand up for your rights is now. I remember in high school, there was a we had a Socratic debate, Socratic seminar, and the idea was to debate whether or not it was good during the the post-Civil War South, if it was better for Black Americans to demand their rights immediately or to wait for them over a slow, long process. And me growing up in, rural Ohio, they were all like, "Well, no, you don't want to rush societal change. Let everything take their time. If it takes 100 years, it takes 100 years." And I'm like, "No, you should just give people their rights now. You shouldn't have people wait for generations because that someone's entire life of just not getting civil liberties is bullshit." And so the sentiment is shared here. I mean, Phil was a left-leaning guy. He was a socialist. And so his politics creep out through his music. If you don't like that, or just say keep politics out of music, I mean, okay. So if you're saying you don't like it, then like that is valid. But if you're saying keep politics out of music, like it's in there, tough shit. Like it's there. Politics is in art. There's political allegories. Like that's just like it's how it is. So if you don't like it, I don't know, find a way to separate yourself from. Like I can enjoy the music of Ted Nugent and not agree with all of his political messages. I can enjoy the music of Frank Stallone and his really shitty political opinions, and have fun with it. You don't have to necessarily agree with the political sentiment of a piece of art or to enjoy it, but if you do agree with it, that gives you that extra layer. So me agreeing with this, I'm like, hell yeah, dude, I'm down for this shit. So yeah, cool stuff. Rewind just a hair. I think the solo is next, so let's get back to it. And then we're gonna shift. So what we had there, we had a nice, tasteful, simple melodic solo, which I assume has to be Scott Gorham. Rabo tends to be a bit flashier. Yeah, so I'm a fake Thin Lizzy expert. I don't know who does every solo on every track. Fake Thin Lizzy fan, Greg. All the people in the Facebook groups are right. Fake fan. I suck. The main things to note there, simple, tasteful solo. Truthfully, it's one of the weaker solos on the album. It's still good, and it fits the song, but it's just not as awesome as other solos on the album. And then the rhythm shifts towards the end of the solo before we get back into the verse, and that rhythm shift and instrumental section will come back later in the song. And honestly, I just kind of zoned out over any lyrics that might have been there. So after all this time, I tell myself that I'm not just wasting time. Oh, I'm not that way inclined. I'm just going to do the rest of the lyrics now. Brothers, fire to fall. It's man for man and one for all. No more can we crawl. Brothers, brothers, hear the call. Spoilers for what we're about to hear. After all this time, I tell myself I'm not just wasting time. Oh, I'm not that way inclined. More of the same, but still works for the piece. So that way I don't have to just try to remember the lyrics and analyze them and see what I miss. So let's just get back to the song.
No more can we crawl.
tell myself that I'm not just wasting time. Oh, you know I'm not that way inclined. Brother, 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 brother,
man, a man, a for all.
Brother, 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 brother,
what you want?
Brother, brother,
we gotta fight for one another.
All right, I'm sorry, that, so I was just enjoying the vamp. That was such a good vocal right there. That was awesome. I had to, like, point that out and pause it. This section right here is bringing back that rhythm that I mentioned. Going into more of, like, an R&B soul thing here. Really, really awesome. And we've got another awesome vamp that is coming. Yep, that's the other awesome vamp. A callback to the song Fighting My Way Back off of the previous album, Fighting. So the way that he did Fight there, that enunciation is pretty much the exact same way he did it on that song. So it's a direct callback to a previous song, you know, but done in a way that's clever. That it's not just like, oh, we're repeating ideas because we ran out of ideas. It's a clever callback, and I think is great. Yeah, big fan.
Brother,
such a good vocal. Alright, so there we go. So that was Fight or Fall, and looks like I am well within the restraints of my lunch break. Because, like I said, been just so slammed busy. Turns out when you add 4 hours of cleaning, like, every day, to try to get rid of fleas, naturally, without harming your pets with chemicals that not only kill the fleas, but kill the pets, turns out, like, trying to do it in a way that's not going to harm your cats, takes a lot of time and energy. It's a lot. But managed to get this Thin Lizzy Thursday done, and you know what? I'm happy with it. This is a great song. You know, this is a nice, always a nice, like, break in my week to, like, enjoy some great music, flap my big yapper, and the people who actually want to hear my big yapper, chatting with you guys about how wrong I am is always great. You know what? I do love this song. I think the thing is, I'm trying too hard to compare it to the other songs in the catalog and not being like, yo, dog, it's just cool for what it is. Like, you know what? I can like Rocky IV and Rocky I. That doesn't mean, like, you know, one of them sucks. They're just great in different ways. So this is great in a different way. But yeah, I dig it. I dig it. I dig it. And now, boys and girls, comes the part where we have to rank it. All right, Fight or Fall. Okay, so definitely better than Emerald. That is the easy marker. You know what? Yeah, better than Angel of Death. Better than Soldier of Fortune. Soldier of Fortune goes a little bit long, so I might put Fight or Fall above it. I think it's just like, I think that song could be a little bit punchier in compared to Fight or Fall. So it's not better than Still in Love with You. So the question is, the parts of Soldier of Fortune I like better than Fight or Fall. But I do think it could be maybe, like, a slightly tighter song. So it's really between... Yeah, is it better than Soldier of Fortune is the question. You know what? I'm going to put it... A rank below Soldier of Fortune. That is where I'm feeling Fight or Fall. Do you agree with me? Probably not. She's like, whoa, you put something from Jailbreak down there. Like, I put Emerald down there too, bro. Like, you know, that's just how I roll. But yeah, that is where I ranked it. it's tough ranking these. And I really want someone to actually take me up on just, like, copy and pasting my ranking and rearranging it. I want to see your guys' rankings. Like, I want to have competing rankings in the comments and then have someone say, you know what, freaking Michael's, you know, he has the best ranking. You know, like, I want, you know what, I want Dream Sketcher's ranking to be the one true Thin Lizzy ranking. That is what I want. But yeah, so that is the video. And shameless plug for the other thing that's making me extremely tired. Radiant Epic, a weekly novel that I've been putting out for a couple months now with a co-writer. So not all the burden is on me, but a good chunk of it. It is about three different characters, and you can guess which characters I'm writing and which character he is writing. So that's kind of fun. But basically, it's a free-to-read novel, new chapters every week. My greatest passion is writing. I did music for 10 years, and then I went back to my original passion, which I've had a passion for since I was a small child. Elevator pitch. It is a fantasy story about three teenagers named Tice, Jenian, and Lyra, who live in the small farm village of Pak in the Kingdom of Godot, which lost a war a few decades ago and is now occupied by the foreign Hafen Empire. And so these three teenagers are living under imperial rule. Americans will probably feel this one pretty hard, and the British folks reading will be like, well, you know, the Hoffins seem reasonable. They're just correct. just a joke for my imperialist friends, even though my country is the imperialist one now. Anyway, so the basic gist is that you've got the three teenagers, and two of them start to date, and one of them feels left out. And also, the one who feels left out also deals with racial bias because, you know, fantasy world and he's a different race and how that interplays into society. As far as reading, it's like 3 hours worth thus far. So it's completely free, new chapters every week. The model is based off of the shonen anime manga model where they like, here's a new chapter of our story every week. So it's based off that model. It's exhausting, but it's a labor of love. If you want to read it, now you know what it's about. So, yes, a fantasy story, and most of it is a teenage romance drama, because that's what you're looking for in your, you know, wizards and fantasy, is just like, here's some teenagers, you know, and, like, the complex feels in here. But, yeah, so that is the ad that I've been meaning to do for a long time. You know what? If I post this in the Facebook groups, I'm going to get shit for talking about my other project in there. But you know what? Like, you got one life to live. And it's cheaper than paying for an ad on someone else's YouTube channel just to do it here. But thank you guys so much for watching Thin Lizzy Thursday. More Thin Lizzy Thursday next week. Next week is a random song, and then after that, we're going back to the fan vote. So going to be doing this back and forth. Yeah, once again, thank you guys so much for your support. It means a lot to me. You know, it's nice that we get to have this every week. It, like I said, it's a highlight for me. Thank you guys so much. And, yeah, I think I'm going to make myself a little sandwich before I clock back into work. So you guys have a good one, and I'll see you next week. Bye, everyone.